Oh, there he is. Oh no, Sam Cedar. What a what a f-ing nightmare. Thank you, Steven. I had no idea this was going to happen. I thought Ethan was a stand-up guy.
Wait, dude. Is this the new one? Oh, it is. Oh my god. It has one view, dude. We're f-ing in. Alright, who's ready for this, dude? I'm like a kid. Like, I'm giddy.
Welcome everybody to a very special episode of the H3 Podcast. Today is my first ever debate against the one and only Steven Crowder. Crowder challenged me to a debate. He called me a layup. He said I was stupid. Well, Steven, I think the debate speaks for itself. Steven Crowder, for those of you that don't know, is probably one of the most hateful, bigoted people on the platform. Racist, homophobic, I mean, pretty much hits every box. We made this big, beautiful compilation of some of his greatest hits, but it's actually so heinous and offensive that YouTube age restricted the first upload of our video. My tiff with Steven came when he said that our clip about COVID, when we were saying it's okay to listen to scientists, said it was his favorite clip of all time. And Steven boldly challenged me to a debate and a video titled, Your Move, Ethan.
I will invite you on the show, Ethan Klein. I will have my, you know what, I'll follow you on Twitter. I will have Darren, my booker, reach out where you can come on this show.
Darren's his dad, by the way, right? Just say your dad, bro. He keeps trying to hide that it's his dad. You guys will get more info about the dad.
That's true.
Now, in our original video about Crowder, we had noticed that he had reached out to me to book me on his show, and he was kind of butthurt that I ghosted him all this time. And in this video, he claims here that he never reached out to a booker and that I'm lying about it. So here's what he says about that.
So you said we'll get to a female booker reached out to you for the show. Hey, Gerald, have I ever had a female booker?
That's a no.
Never,
that's
ever, negative. Ever. Now you're either lying.
We don't work with women on this show. So that's impossible. I took this to heart. So I said, you know what, Steven? I am going to look into this. I found the email that was sent to me. It was very professional. It still had her social media contacts on it. And so I followed her down on Instagram. And I said, hey, blank, did you ever do booking for Louder with Crowder? I'm just trying to verify that this email I got from you inviting me on the show is real or not. Thanks. She immediately responded to me. She said, yes, I did booking for him years ago for a few months. I'm not quite sure whose contact you have now. I know his dad does his booking for him, though. Let me know if you need it to try his finest contact. Interesting that she knows that detail. That makes me think that is very real. And that he's lying about inviting me on his show. How odd. And while we're talking about lying, Steven, why don't you tell him that you never filed a lawsuit? Tell us if you filed that lawsuit against YouTube, Steven. Come on, be honest with your viewers. Mm. And you know, Steven says he doesn't want to bully me, but here he goes on to say this. And I am feeling very insecure now that Steven has taken a shot at me.
Listen, dude, Ethan, you got the holsters now. It's good. At first, you didn't have holsters. So obviously, what would you call it? A holster lit? Like a manlet, but like a holster lit? But now you got the holsters.
We were making fun of the fact that Steven had Kleenex on his table, which is pretty funny, let's be honest. He's sitting there with gun holsters and tissue.
Wait,
I gotta take the gun out
for this again. I don't have a holster, but at least I have a Glock. It's an airsoft. It's not a real gun. Okay, calm down. But, you know, it's for ambiance. It's because, I just, you know, it's like a fan piece. Like, I love Steven Crowder.
In immutable condition. Oh. It's genetic.
Oh, poor Steven with his allergies. Don't put the tissue on your desk. It's funny. All right, don't get so twisted up. Look how twisted he gets about me laughing about him crying all the time. He needs a box of tissue on his desk.
But I guess there's a ceasefire here so we can talk about any genetic conditions like sure. The lack of chin, lack of beard, 120-pound man wearing the Cinderella bandana on his head.
That one I didn't get. What's the 120-pound man?
I couldn't really
follow. If he's talking about me, I am not 120-pound. Trust me, dude.
What the fuck?
Well, anyway.
Steven Crowder doesn't have the... He can't be calling nobody chinless, dude. He's literally like a beard fish. You know what I mean? Like, you know, hat fishing when you're bald and you hide your baldness? Like, he literally makes up his lack of chin with like a beard line. Like, he tries to do that.
And to compensate with a beard that he uses just for men or the...
Wait, but he's doing that. He literally does that.
That's
eyebrow
my favorite.
Phrase like E.T. in the cornfield. It's so stupid, bro. The point is...
Wait, isn't that a tit? What the fuck?
I always think it's like... hilarious when people actually go to the debase themselves to making fun of my Tourette. You know, it's
what
like, okay,
fuck, dude. Oh my god,
I really
god,
got he's... you hard with the tissue thing, bro. Just don't put the tissue on. I can't hide my Tourette.
You fired the first volley by making fun of his allergies.
So. Your allergies, dude.
Yikes.
By
the way, Steven Crowder is such a fucking douchebag that him being like so openly ableist towards Ethan here. It's like on the laundry list. I'm just surprised he didn't get like hyper anti-Semitic. You know what I mean? Like that was, it's such a fucking, oh God, he's such a bully, dude. He is such a literal fucking bully. It's wild.
Dan had this one moment that actually went a little bit viral in the political community that Steven notably ignored during our tit for tat. I'll play it for you here. And this is where
that
I'm leading
to. A lot of people, but just because I feel like there's a decent chance Steven Crowder will see this and this will be the only time that I get to say this. Debate Sam Cedar, dude. Stop being such a pussy. I know that your dad doesn't want you to. But that was a long time ago. That was you're 3 years older now. It's time. It's time to debate Sam.
And notably, he doesn't include this. He watches the whole clip, but not the debate Sam Cedar.
Weird he didn't cover that part. He went into a lot of detail on everything else.
Oh, yeah. Oh, exhaustive detail. Huh. Sam Cedar is the host of a political left-leaning show called The Majority Report. Has 1 million subs. He's a big channel. Crowder famously backed out of a scheduled debate with Sam at Politicon, earning him the name Cold Feet Crowder. At the behest of his dad, Sam secretly recorded the phone call with the organizer of the event, who exposed Crowder. Here's the call.
Yeah, that's a real shame.
I think you're bigger. I don't know what his team is doing around him, and that's, you know, just for me to speculate at this point. I don't know.
He has a team? He has a whole team, and he won't do it? He can bring the team.
I believe it's his father, but I can't confirm or deny that.
By the way, everyone seems to be confirming that it's his dad doing all this shit behind the scenes somehow. He actually backed out of the debate because Sam is actually, you know, an informed, good debater. They were afraid that, you know, Crowder would look like an idiot. And so he backed out at the last minute at the behest of his father. The thing is, he's happy to challenge me, somebody that has no political knowledge, very little. I don't spend my day talking and thinking about politics, nor am I a debater, nor am I, let's be honest, intelligent.
Same.
Let's be honest. So with all that being said, we figured let's get someone who is familiar with the topics, who does spend their time thinking about politics, and who is, you know, unlike me, smart. So we've got a little surprise for Steven Crowder. So let's all enjoy the debate.
Dude, he fucking primed this up so well, dude. Ethan just lubed this all up so well. Oh, God. Okay, are you guys ready for this fucking roller coaster, dude? Holy shit. Oh, my God. Oh, fuck. Okay, let's go.
People
let's do it.
Who,
buckle up.
Enter into the arena. You know him. Some of you like him. Some of you don't. Same can be said for me. Ethan Klein from H3H3. Ethan, thanks, man, for making the time.
You're very welcome. And I just want to say, I know you called me.
His voice is trembling already.
You said that I would be a layup. Which is fine.
And
I think you're right, because I don't think I'm a very good debater. I think you know that. So I didn't want to make it too easy for you.
Oh, okay.
So I've prepared.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, so
Dan,
what we were going to talk about is, you know, the initial quote that happened. I think he's looking off there. The initial quote that kind of was turned into a little bit of a meme, which wasn't intentional, and was you saying you don't even have to think about it regarding the CDC. And I disagree with that. I think people should think about it, I believe. And we talked about this through playful ribbing in an aggregation of medical authorities and scientific voices to make an informed and rational decision. So where do you think that I'm wrong on that?
Steven, do you know that the Spartans are like practice man love with children?
Oh, geez. Okay, so this is what's going to happen. What did I tell you? He was going to do anything he could to avoid. Oh, there he is. Oh, no. Sam Cedar. What a fucking nightmare.
Thank you, Steven.
I had no idea this was going to happen. I thought Ethan was a stand-up guy.
Wait. Dude. Oh, we gotta run that again. Oh my God, he's literally like worried. That's why he's scared, because he did this already. If you saw earlier when I talked to Ethan, like, he was watching to make sure that Sam Cedar was not going to come in, because they suspected that Sam Cedar was going to come into this debate. That's why he's trembling. Look at this.
I believe And we talked about this through playful ribbing in an aggregate. So where do you think that I'm wrong on that? Oh, there he is. Oh no, Sam Cedar. What a fucking nightmare. I had no idea this was going to happen. I thought Ethan was a stand-up guy. This is where we are. Yeah, I told Dave, remember I told you?
Well, I just think he believes that he should debate you.
No, he doesn't. He just takes advantage of women with, you know, mental health issues. Ethan Klein doesn't stand up and do his own fighting.
I gotta say,
wait, what?
It's just hilarious. Let's bring on FM.
You would do anything to avoid talking to me. I think the point that you made
at the beginning of this Rogan.
Yeah, Joe Rogan and Ben Shapiro and Dave Rubin and Jordan Peterson and Noam Chomsky and Sam Harris. Everyone's been avoiding.
Just attempting to get your audience by jumping in.
Well, I debated with Charlie Kirk. Stephen, I mean, it's about issues. Let's talk about those issues.
That's what you're doing here.
Valid points.
You're so clever. I had no idea that you were taking.
Showing Stephen Crowder. Go back to Stephen Crowder. I don't give a fuck about like Stephen Crowder's B team, dog. Oh my God. Hey boys, frame shattered. Okay. That's a Sigma male right there. The Sigma male, Sam Cedar, dude. Absolutely frame annihilated, okay? Steven Crowder has no frame. He's off the frame because he has no frame now. Oh, he is so mad. This is so
Can your show off early last time coming in today with your pig pen peanuts eyes.
I wish everything...
You take those off with the velveteen buttons.
We must have been black very worried about this, Stephen. I don't know why.
No one's worried about it, Sam.
So
I didn't want to do it.
Let's have
Sam,
a debate.
Come
if
on.
No
I'll
worried,
tell you what. I have a general
This is a great opportunity.
I don't start a debate based with people on a lie. And how about you get
sabotaging.
How about you get
Stephen,
to a
show yourself,
of the audience
you coward.
Share.
Stephen, show yourself. Don't show your co-host.
Ethan, you should show yourself.
Ethan, how can you respect yourself as a man, brother?
Stephen, you are such a coward. Stop showing your little leprechaun co-host who comes out dressed like
Ethan,
your sidekick.
Come on, Ethan, why do you have to bring
show Steven?
That's the best thing I've ever heard. So you have a guy with less viewers to come on to debate him because you can't?
Obviously, I'm a layup and not a debater.
Well, look, you're the one who called. You're the one who got started.
God damn, dude. He's like, he is balking like a fucking chicken over here, dude. Oh my Lord. He won't even show his face. Come on, dude. Come on. This is the juicy content. We only got to see like 3 seconds of him so triggered and so upset, dude. Oh, what a gift. What a gift. Oh, God. This is wonderful, dude. This is making me so happy. Oh, Jesus.
Let me hear what Pigpen has to say here really quick.
Fair enough.
Why are they saying Pigpen? Like, is that, like, what is the flex there? Like, that Sam doesn't have, like, rich backers or some shit? Like, what's the problem?
Hold on a second, Ethan. This is because initially I came on here to talk with Ethan. Ethan, come on, man. The same reason that I haven't ever had a conversation with Sam Cedar is the same reason that Joe Rogan, Sam Harris, Brett Weinstein, Dave Rubin, Ben Shapiro don't owe him anything. It's based on a lie, Ethan.
What's the lie?
There's no one ducking you,
Why
Sam.
Are you
I've
so
never
afraid.
Sam,
yo,
Sam,
listen,
Sam, Sam,
I think
Sam,
you're
Sam.
A smart guy.
I can call out Mike Tyson.
I don't
Tyson.
Understand why
it doesn't mean
you
that I'm ducking
are
him.
So worried about this.
Why do you feel that? Do you feel that anyone, Sam? Why do you feel that anyone owes you airtime when you have a 40th of the audience and you've been doing
I
a show?
I don't think anybody.
Oh my God, he's like, I'm not ducking you. I'm just, you know, you just don't have that big of an audience. God damn, dude. I mean, in some ways, I do understand. Like, I wouldn't fucking debate someone who's like significantly smarter than me unless it was like good content. But it's not like Sam Cedar is like a tiny creator. He's one of the largest fucking voices on the left. Also, speaking of larger voices on the left, so what's up? If I fucking hit up Steven Crowder, like, would he debate me then? I mean, I'm here. I got 54,000 people watching right now. Like, I would 100% do it. Like, it's not like these dudes are, I don't know, avoiding these people on the virtue of, like, their audience size or anything like that. Or, sorry, being informed is 57,000 now. I mean, you know.
He can't build an audience, and so what happens is he uploads 15 times more, has less than a 50th of the audience.
Well, that's why he wants to debate you, is so he can build his...
Sam, come on.
Do you think your audience cares that I only have 1 million subscribers and you have, what, 6 or 7 million subscribers?
He should have been like, yeah, what's up? On those Change My Mind videos, do you fucking make sure that, like, the college campus freshmen that you're talking to have, like, the appropriate amount of audience? Or do you only care about that when you know you can just, like, easily fucking dunk on college freshmen with, like, talking points that you got from the Heritage Foundation? Because that's the fucking point.
Can I answer your question? Sure. You want me to answer your question? My audience would say Sam who? Just like Joe Rogan's audience and Ben Shapiro's and Dave Rubin.
Now they all know who I am.
Now they all know who you are because you had to shoehorn yourself into another Howard show.
College students, every day that you do that, change my mind.
This is another lie. Let me clarify, Sam. The Change My Mind, everyone knows on the show, right? We've had professors on the
show. I ended my show early last week, Steven. If your audience doesn't
Because you're an idiot,
How
and half of your
that?
Staff doesn't
do you
like
my
you.
Show?
Because I'm a diehard fan.
Yes, it's because he's a diehard fan.
If you're
I've
a diehard
heard
hard
of you,
fan,
but I just
why,
met you.
Why not?
Congratulations, Sam Cedar's fan.
Steven,
I'm just
have
a
conversation.
Huge fan.
I will talk
right
about
every time
issues
I try and
that
talk,
you want to talk
about, Sam.
Steven.
Yeah, right now, I'm trying to talk with you. You're interrupting, Sam.
You bombarded the show.
Okay, you bombarded my show under a false pretense. You claim that ever, just like you claim that I ducked a debate with you under a false pretense. Have I ever?
That is what the Politicon people told me.
Oh, is that what they told you? Well, so you're just lazy with your research?
What research? What do you mean? If the fucking event organizers say that, like, you didn't want to debate, then what further research is necessary? And you very clearly have made attempts not to debate him. Also, having said all this, the irony is, like, it's obvious that he was expecting Sam to show up and wasn't very comfortable about it. He clearly fucking knows who Sam is. I would go so far as to say he's Sam's number one fan, making sure that he knows at any given moment what Sam is up to. So, oh, God forbid he would have to debate him. Well, guess what? It's happening now. My Lord, dude. Hey, what's up, conservative? Conservatives are so fucking big. They're so fucking tough until, you know, they actually have to talk to someone who knows what the fuck they're talking about. In which case, look how quickly he became this, like, cowering little baby. Like, he is, like, legitimately afraid. It's wild, dude. You're an adult man. Just stand by your convictions, repeat the fucking think tank talking points, and see where it takes you. I don't get it. I don't know why you're so triggered. I don't know why you're so mad.
Sam, sweetheart. Sam, fake stand-up comic who we can't find any footage about online. Let
I'm
me
not
finish.
A damn, dude. It's like, damn, he Googled him, dude. Clearly, you've, like, looked it up. That's Sam behavior, bro. Did you want to find a stand-up comedy so you could, you know, cut it into one of those, like, K-pop stan style fan cams, dude? Is that why you wanted to find a stand-up, dude? God damn, dude. He's so butthurt. That's crazy. Also, the irony. The irony's so thick that Steven Crowder, the most unfunny person on the planet, would literally test the comedy credentials of another human being, let alone Sam Cedar, who is, like, you know, he's still, like, a voice actor, shit like that. You know what I mean? He's been in, like, comedy shows and whatnot, and not just Arthur, which Steven Crowder was a part of. Like, that blows my mind, dude. Blows my fucking mind. How do you measure someone's comedy metrics, dude? I'm sorry, Sam. You're not funny. You don't do enough racial slurs, okay? It's not for me. Now, my taste is doing minstrel shows or doing AAVE when describing black farmers. Like, that's my humor. My humor is so advanced at a level that you can't comprehend that, like, when Ethan wants to fucking play a compilation of my greatest hits, YouTube automatically fucking age restricts it. You know, that kind of humor.
Everything that I've seen is incredibly unfunny and unentertaining,
well,
which may
I'm
explain the audience.
Irony alert, Steven.
Comedian.
How much have you
comedian.
Watched of my stuff,
the
Steven,
irony
that you
alert.
Think
Sam,
that your audience
can I answer
would
your question?
Appreciate our discussing
Sam,
things?
Sam, because you said, I want to speak with Steven Crowder. You believe that at some point there was some acceptance? When have I ever done a Politicon? As a matter of fact, in the last decade, I haven't done a single political conference.
How
I hosted CPAC for 4 years and stopped because they suck. They don't
say,
pay
okay.
and they're full of losers.
What about Gavin
and you've been
McGinnis's
clamoring
show?
For it and
Gavin
it's a lie.
Told me that you dropped out of doing
how
his
can you
show
say
because
that you,
this is just hearsay and gossip.
But how can
I
you
say I've never met more of a woman
career when he wants to keep debating.
Damn, that's that Jesse Lee Peterson line, dude. I've never met more of a woman. You know, you do gossip. Dude, you literally just spent the first, like, 10 minutes crying about how he doesn't have the credentials, talking about how you, like, literally Googled his stand-up to try to find if he had, like, any stand-up out there, failed, got mad. I don't know, man. It seems like, yeah, that's an L, boys. That's an L for Steven L. Crowder right here. What a fucking L nerd.
So, Ethan, do you want to have a conversation, Ethan?
Let's talk about the vaccine. Because
Ethan, do you want to have a conversation? You're going to hide.
Absolutely, I do. So why are you hiding behind Sam Cedar?
Oh, no. No, me and Sam are aligned. I'm not hiding. He just
knows
the issue.
Well, you're just a liar. Because remember, we said, hold on a second.
I mean, it sort of feels like you guys are the ones who are hiding.
Who's the guy who never appears on stage, never does a live show,
but it's
never even sheds, never even allows a shadow of comedy to be perceived on his program? It's just hiding. Right. Everything we do is out in the open. H3,
Steven,
you know,
you're wearing a holster.
We agreed.
So what?
Hold on a second, yeah? So? I want to normalize responsible gun ownership. Is that your debate? No wonder you had to bring in a hack for you.
Well, no, you're talking about comedy.
That's a debate strategy.
That's not very funny.
You have a holster, bro.
Also, you're a holster.
As he takes advantage of mentally ill women for a show with just about
gay boy love.
Okay.
All of it.
All right, Sam. You got it. You got it. I hope you have a wonderful highlight reel.
Hold on. Let me just make one point.
Okay, there's got to be a point where they debate, right? They're not just like yelling over one another. God damn, dude. Steve Crowder is doing the ultimate manly move, which is yell hysterically when you feel as though you've been backed into a corner, that corner being somewhere that he's supposed to be super comfortable in, which is debating. Because, you know, remember, all of this started when Crowder on the Rogan show said that the left doesn't want to debate him because they're too cowardly. Remember, it doesn't seem like he doesn't want to debate at all here, but maybe I'm wrong.
We enjoy Politicon.
Hold on, let me make one point, Steven.
Take it easy.
Steven, right, don't bail. Don't bail, you coward.
Hey, Sam, one thing before I go. Can you take off your glasses? Steven,
hold on.
One thing before I go. Can you take off your glasses?
We just want to see.
I just want to see if you take them off, if you have the Velveteen Rabbit buttons. That's the only thing I'm curious about. It's the only interesting part about
it. Or if there's a soul.
Let's debate.
Take off the glasses.
What does that mean? Like, when Steven Crowder says something, I'm like, is this advanced racism? You know what I mean? Like, maybe I don't understand it. Like, what was he trying to say? Like, what is the reference there? Is that like advanced anti-Semitism, maybe? Like, what are these references, bro? God damn. I think he meant Coraline. I don't know what that is. What is he trying to say? I don't know. Maybe he has a really funny joke ultimately behind that statement.
Don't say let's debate, Ethan. You've lost. Debate the issues.
What does it matter who you debate, coward?
All right, good. You guys are good. Thank you.
Coward.
Won't even take off the glasses.
I was right.
All right, yeah. You can run away
twice. Cold feet again.
Come on, Steven.
Wow.
Wait, did he leave? That can't be it.
Dude, I can't believe he admit to following.
He admitted that he followed the show last week.
We got him.
He watched the show last week. We got him early.
We played him so hard because he literally was following. He saw that you went live, dude. We fucking got him.
Oh my God. We fucking nailed him.
I cannot believe he just ran away. I cannot believe he literally just ran away. I really thought that he was going to have more to say than this. That's so wild. He just fucking cried the entire time, admitted to watching him, admitted to like following his every footsteps to ensure that I guess like they never run into one another on the internet. Hassan, you really thought he'd debate? Yeah, dude, what the fuck? Half the time he wouldn't even show his face. That's crazy, dude.
He's obviously lying about the idea that he wouldn't want to do a debate with me because his audience wouldn't know. Here's a guy who literally tracked my show last week because he was afraid that this would happen. Here's a guy who claims to have watched, I don't know. I don't know what it is he said he watched, but
I can't believe Steven Crowder literally fucking made fun of Ethan's Tourette's and then spent like 15 minutes crying while simultaneously admitting to like literally fucking Googling everything about Sam Cedar. Clearly, that's not something you do when this is like an irrelevant person in your life. Like, how much fucking real estate does Sam Cedar occupy in Steven Crowder's already tiny brain? Yo, conservatives are so strange, dude. You know, using woman as an insult, saying you're gossiping, like, that's so crazy. Now I want to know how Steven Crowder is going to try to, like, spin this into, I don't know, somehow that he won this. Like, Crowder is having Trump Jr. on tomorrow to distract from this L. I mean, yeah, have a gigantic loser. This close to Father's Day, Steven Crowder, he's going to be, Donald Trump Jr. is not going to be in the right mental mindset to be on the show. You know what I'm saying? Like, He's not in a good mindset right now. This close to Father's Day, you know, he's thinking about how Donald literally doesn't respond to him. So H3H3 spends weeks slagging off Crowder. Then when he finally agrees to a debate, he's so weak and unable to man up on his own, he has to get someone else to hold his hand and calls it a win-law. What difference does it make? Like, what a lot of conservatives don't recognize for some weird reason is like Ethan is literally admitting. Like, he's admitting that, like, he's not the right person to fucking... to do this sort of debate. Like, he's saying, like, I'm not, like, very politically minded. You know, I'm not a politics guy. I'm not a debate guy. I'm not even smart. Like, so someone who is as big-brained as Steven Crowder should have no problem debating someone with a tiny brain like Sam Cedar with a tiny audience. You know what I mean? So it's rather odd that he would throw a fit like this. It's so funny that, like, he's basically saying, like, no, I only like to debate people that I can fucking steamroll over. Not saying that Steven Crowder would be able to steamroll Ethan either, but who he perceives he has an easy go at it.
Sam, and do you think that the size of your sub count is there a correlation to your skills as a debater? That seems to be what Crowder's understanding is.
Apparently. Yeah. Or it's just that he is looking for any excuse to why he doesn't want to have a conversation with somebody.
Why exactly are they pointing out the sub count / audience? Like, why does it matter in this debate? It matters in the debate. Like, if Steven Crowder is the type of person who, like myself, admits that, like, debates are fucking just purely for entertainment and not necessarily, like, changing anybody's minds, which, of course, that's not what Steven Crowder admits. He literally says the exact opposite of that, which is why his show is unironically called Change My Mind. He would say, like, why the fuck would I platform someone else when it's not going to be any benefit to me? That's my take on why I don't, like, fucking lend credence to, like, every dipshit that is like, oh my god, I want to debate you, Hassan. I'm doing a video on how much you suck or whatever. It's like, yeah, I don't give a fuck. I'm not a great debater, and I don't think the debates are productive to begin with, which is why I wouldn't do it. Having said that, there aren't a lot of left-wing content creators that are all that sizable in the end, and Sam is still one of the biggest ones. If I am currently the biggest one, then Sam is still one of the top 5 to 10 left-wing commentators out there currently. For him to simultaneously hold the position that debates are good and you can change people's minds, want to debate other people routinely as a part of his content, and then lastly, literally for him to act like he wants to debate people on the left only to run away from one of the more prominent left-wing commentators implies that, you know, there's a little bit of a mismatch there with the goals and the ideas and the values that he espouses and what he truly believes. And that's the whole point. Having said that, I mean, I would fucking debate Steven Crowder. I would. But I high-key doubt that he would be down to do such a thing either. So I think, like, the main thing that he admitted here that's, like, pretty whack for Steven Crowder most likely is the fact that he is obsessed. And while he simultaneously said, oh, I don't know you, my audience would say, who are you? Well, it seems like Steven Crowder knows exactly who the fuck Sam Cedar is. As a matter of fact, I would go so far as to say Steven Crowder is the biggest fan of Sam Cedar. Like, knowing exactly when he's live, knowing exactly when he's not live, being afraid that he was going to potentially come on to Ethan's broadcast. Seems like not only has he watched a lot, but he's also Googled, like, to see if there's any background information on Sam.
Who is he supposed to debate then, if not you?
I don't know.
Yeah, me? I'm not a political debater. I'm just some dumbass. Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe he's trolling through to find, like, you know, like makeup tutorial sites that have like 2 million subscribers. Yeah. Or, I mean, anybody who doesn't
Minecrafters
know.
Have a lot of subs.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I think a Minecrafter could roll Steven Crowder. Like, if properly coached on what the talking points are, I think Minecrafters, by virtue of, like, osmosis and learning, like, talking points from their audience, like, their Radlib audience members, could probably roll Steven Crowder, honestly. I mean, it's great. This is wonderful.
There's some Minecrafters my son watches that maybe he'd like to debate on some of these issues.
Right.
Sam Cedar's children, Carl Jacobs fans, confirmed. Sam Cedar's children, Dream fans, confirmed. Yeah. How do you expect a person to debate after trying to take over his show, essentially? I mean, I don't know. It's not like he's an intellectual giant. Like, he's a fucking warlord. Like, Steven Crowder is an intellectual warlord. If your argument is that, like, you know, how is he supposed to just, like, debate Sam Seder? Like, I mean, Sam is just, he doesn't have the mental fortitude to take on a giant like Steven Crowder. Steven Crowder was ready for a debate with Ethan on a particular subject. If Ethan going turning around and being like, hey, I'm not going to do this, but here, I have someone who is, like, smarter than me to do this for me, then why shouldn't he be able to do that? He's a literal champion of logic and reasoning. He is a, so as predicted, everyone on the left, things, Ethan's pathetic deception was the end, justify the means, and everyone on the right thinks Steven totally owned. Of course, it's neither, and the world is now dumber for watching. Now, excuse me while I make 8 videos about it. The Quarter Pounder never stops, dude. You know, things keep happening. They keep happening, and Quarter Pounder will make content out of it. Does he? I thought he was, like, off Twitter. What happened?
I don't have enough subscribers to earn the respect to enter the ring. When you enter the ring,
a million
you
is
must
a lot,
do so.
It's apparent. I
like, it doesn't matter how little subs Sam Seder has. If you are openly stating that you've, like, tracked his movement on the internet, do you see what I'm saying? Crowder got himself in a bind here, because if he truly doesn't know who Sam Seder is because of how, like, you know, tiny of a content creator Sam Seder is, then he shouldn't be so scared. He would just be like, oh yeah, like, whatever. I'll just take you down like I would any other college freshman, right? If he admits to knowing who Sam Seder is, then he knows that Sam Seder and a pretty sizable audience that he has, a sizable audience that he commands, has wanted to, you know, talk to Steven Crowder for quite some time now. I mean, he openly admitted it. He said, I knew this was going to happen. Why would you fear someone who is so insignificant, you know? It just doesn't make sense. The irony, of course, is, yeah, he was wearing a fucking literal fight like hell shirt. I just want to run this part again, dude. It's so good. This is such a good fucking moment.
Is what we were going to talk about is, you know, the initial quote that happened. I think he's looking off there. The initial quote that...
Why is he so nervous? Like, did he think that Steven Crowder was going to show up? Did he know?
Kind of.
Oh, did I say, does he know Steven Crowder is coming? I meant, yeah, Sam Seder. Does he know Sam Seder is on the other side?
Oh, there he is. Oh no, Sam Seder. What a fucking nightmare.
What a fucking nightmare. Like, what the fuck, dude? What a fucking loser, dude. Straight up. Listen, all I'm gonna say is this, okay? This man show up on your Zoom call is, oh no, what a fucking nightmare. Like, it's just not gonna get better after that. It's over. This is a major self-report, dude.
I had no idea this was going to happen.
God, it's so good. Oh, what a nightmare. I had no idea this was going to happen. What is this? We just cut to a live feed of Sam Seder. Change my diaper. Oh, God. I really wish that, like, Joe Rogan wasn't such a fan of, like, Sam Harris and Dave Rubin as much, but, like, and would just have Sam Seder on, you know what I mean? That'd be good. I think that would be really good. Problem is that, like, the online left is growing as a community and in size, but I think Sam Seder on Joe Rogan would be interesting. And I think that would, like, give the online left a lot more clout. And also on top of that, it would give it more, like, legitimacy in the eyes of all of these, like, conservative debate lords. You know what I mean? All I'm going to say is this. Joe Rogan, get on the right side, okay? You know Joe Rogan. You know what the trends look like, okay? The time for right-wing broadcasting on the internet is coming to a close. A lot of these guys are clown asses. You know, you've hyped up a lot of them at the time. You don't do it as much anymore. Start hyping up left-wing broadcasters, Joe Rogan. Get on the right side. All right. Ultimately, boys, what do I think about this? Okay. Ultimately, all in all, I really do wish that there was more. Like, it left me craving. You know what I mean? We got, like, a little tease. We got, like, a little tease of what was going on. And I really do wish that that it was longer than the 10 minutes of just, like, Steven Crowder fucking crying that, like, he had to be around Sam Seder. But he was louder than everybody else.